one inch. This is a scandal. So for you to come here as MPs and you just sit, members of parliament, honourable, what? The whole day. Standing, sitting down, point of order, point of information. You look like clowns in that parliament there. You are like in a theater, just acting. Your people are carrying water on their heads. Your mothers, your grandmothers, your sisters who have remained in the village, and you are just here, we're wasting time. I really am not happy with the way you conduct yourselves. The theater. You are like in a theater. When will the people, all the homesteads in your village, get income? When will they get good houses? When will they get electricity instead of women who tremor? When will they get water, safe water and piped water? The mode of transport. That's what we mean by socio-economic transformation. Some of the families have transformed. In my family, Kaguta was the last peasant, was the last village person. They are no longer there, those villagers. But the others, it's not good that Museveni's family transforms, but the neighbors remain in the pre-capitalist mode of life. So that principle, socio-economic transformation, we shall scrutinize it in more detail later. And then democracy. Democracy, of course, is clear. It's simple. Then toward the end, we shall see how all this will help you to be a leader, even without much campaigning. By solving people's problems, you may not need to campaign much. And by solving them, don't make the mistake of wanting to use your pocket to solve their problems. That's what has killed your predecessors. Bani Mabanja, why should you borrow money to solve people's problems? You are not a bank, you are not a circle. Why should you use your pocket? The leader is to show the way. The leader shows the way. You don't carry people on your head. You show them the way, and it's very possible. Even here, there are some of you who have been elected without using a lot of money, without using money, except there is my son from Kagadi, the son of Karori Kamanyira. Where is that boy? Is he here? You come here and give your testimony. Come here. You can speak good English or you only know Nyoro. If you don't know English, you speak in Nyoro, I will translate for you. Now, that's one of the children I educated, but he was elected recently without using you. Tell them what you.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency. I'm Fred Byamukama, MP elected Ganga East West constituency. I'm 29 years old. Me and my campaigns, I used the fuel which was even contributed by the voters. and I could visit them, tell them what I want to do, and tell them what NRM has done. Then the facilitation we got from NRM, it was COVID time, I used it to support the members to impose the COVID restrictions. Thank you very much.
So you didn't borrow money, you didn't?
I didn't, Your Excellency, I did not.
So there you are now. But what, your name is Biamkama?
Yes, Your Excellency.
What Biamkama did not tell you is that his father, Kamanyire, has been very active in the coffee. You tell them that.
My father, Mzee Kamanyire Karoli, a resident of Chikwaya, most of you know Birembo, is a civilian veteran and he's not educated. So when the war ended, for him, he embarked on agriculture. So he has been dealing in coffee. He goes, tells the coffee growers how to come up with good coffee. He partners with other buyers. He buys it, processes it. Then he sells the seedlings. And that's why how he has managed to bring us up.
So the goodwill for the boy was partly because of the work of the father.
Thank you very much, Your Excellency.
Go and sit. But you see, the father was not giving them money. He was only buying their coffee. By solving their problems. So now, finally, we shall talk about mass issues. The mass issues, which are the issues that affect the people. When you read these two documents, and toward the end, I will give you another two, then we can come to a conclusion, so that this parliament, really, the area members, we get rid of poverty in our rural areas, and we work together to telescope the budget, solving people's problems instead of giving ourselves allowances, then traveling, then what? In the end, you get into problems. Some of the problems we have in areas like Kampala, we are sure to come, because in Kampala you have those young people from poor families, not educated. NRM introduced UPE 1996, but your people have made it fail. We spend money, UPE, but the head teachers are still charging money. Now, because the headmasters are still charging money, they have refused to implement UPE. Because of that, many children drop out of school. So it is that group of school dropouts that has built up in numbers, and now you get this problem of the youth. It was created by the leaders. That problem of the youth was created by the leaders, because they refused to implement free education. Because me, I wanted free education. They have made it impossible. The head teachers, they refuse. And you, the leaders, you allow them, because you don't want to antagonize them. You get the something they call PTA, the Parent Teachers Association, which is composed of the head teacher plus a few rich people, local rich people, local traders, who want to get money from children, lunch, I don't know what. They use all sorts of pretexts to get money from the people. Then the children drop out of school. Those children who are dropping out of school are the ones who will become a problem. They are the ones you see who are now joining NUP. So this time we must insist on free education. Anybody who does not implement it must leave the teaching service, must go. Because they are creating a problem for us. I had a meeting at Kehangara. Is there somebody from Uganda? Who is from Uganda here? Have you ever seen people from Uganda? You come here and they see you. These people have never seen how the Wanyiwanda look like. Come here and they see you. See that Mnyiwanda with a big stomach. You come there. Okay. Now you tell these people about, is it Kehangara Secondary School? What is that school? Is it Kehangara or what? You see that Uganda people are well fed?
Yes. Thank you, His Excellency. It is called Kehangara Seed School.
Seed school.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. You're going to see. Now, I had with Biaba Gambi, we had a public meeting there. And I was talking about this refusal to implement free education by the teachers, by the head teachers. The local elite, Banasomako Abombiaro. They are the ones who have refused to implement UPE. So, and USE. So I was speaking at that school, it was a bit late in the evening, and the public were there. I said, you people, you have refused to implement UPE and USE. Because they were trying to say that if you don't charge, education quality will go down. Educational quality will go down. That's when they charge the educational quality, I don't know what. Then my question was, can the parents afford about 80% of the people said they cannot afford. And you know that they cannot afford because you could see these young mothers, somebody is in her 30s, she already has 6 children. And she doesn't have a good source of income because you have not solved the problem of household income. You have not solved it. We shall talk about it in more detail. So if they don't have household income, how would they have money to pay for education? So these 80% of the crowd said, no, we cannot afford. But then there was one, I think she's like a teacher, who stood up and said, no, nibejiza, okwejiza. In Uganda, you, I think, machita, okwekwa.